Hi friends, in pursuit of the Holy Father's call to observe this month as an extraordinary missionary month, our beloved Archbishop, Most Reverend Dr. Peter Machado, has taken upon this mission upon himself and has been able to draw a series of programs and events to mark this event to be a memorable event. Now, this event of extraordinary missionary month is coming with a theme: you are baptized and sent forth. Therefore, in order to make this possible, here we are this morning. We are so happy, blessed and privileged to have beloved Archbishop here in our studios this morning and to share his thoughts and his mission in the Archdiocese of Bangalore. Good morning and welcome, dear Archbishop. Archbishop, you have been in Belgaum for over 2 or 3 years as Bishop, and have assumed office here almost over a year. As Archbishop of Bangalore, a big diocese in the Karnataka. What do you feel, what is your experience as far as the mission is concerned?
Mr. Kantaraj, I'm very happy you have referred to the extraordinary missionary month. You know, it was a very happy experience for me to come here from Rome and land exactly in this moment when the diocese, Archdiocese, is talking about missionary activities. To tell you honestly, meeting the Holy Father was itself a great experience. And you know that he exuberates vibes that are missionary. He himself was a missionary. And therefore, I think we have gained a lot from this trip to Rome, meeting the Holy Father, going around a little. And I was very happy that in the Archdiocese, you are all immersed in the different activities, different programs, preachings, experiences of the missionary month. You asked me about Belgaum. Yes, I was there for 12 years. And Belgaum is a small diocese, but missionary diocese. A small diocese, but with a lot of missions. In fact, except for the city of Belgaum, Hubli and Dharwad, the rest of the diocese was one big mission. Population-wise, the Christians were just 25,000 in the whole diocese. Okay. I would say there are parishes here who have more than 25,000 people in one parish. You can imagine. So in that sense, but we had good priests, the priests who loved the missions, who spent their time and energy for the missions. And for me also, it was a very happy experience going around, meeting the priests and religious, and at the same time meeting the people. What struck me most was, though the conveniences are not there, though the comforts are not as good as Bangalore, but still the zeal for the missions and the faith of the people, I would say, was most edifying for me.
That's fine, Your Grace. But then what is evangelization? A common man today, evangelization means he connects with preaching the good news of God. But what do you feel? Do you think that there are different dimensions for evangelization?
Surely. First of all, knowing your God, or the experience of the love of God yourself. We can't give to others what we don't have ourselves. If I have not experienced God, I would be just giving sermons and sayings and perhaps examples, but I wouldn't be communicating God himself. And therefore, first and foremost thing, I think that we have to experience God ourselves. Secondly, activity does not mean just speaking, talking, preaching. It also means giving our love, our religious aspect to the people in the form of experience. And there are 100 ways I can communicate God to the others. My works of charity, goodness, my being honest, my doing my duty, reaching out to the people when they are in need, and especially with a concern for the poor. I think God is preached much more and more sincerely.
I agree with you, Grace, because our very life should be a gospel to show the face of a God in our very living. But then, as you said, each parish is over 25,000 compared to Belgaum, 25,000 families. But then, as a pastoral and administrative responsibility, which alters your responsibility, how well do you balance in a big archdiocese like Bangalore?
Yeah, surely we need some structures. We need some info, what's it called, the organizations. We need money. We need people. We need personnel. But the focus is in God, the love of God. And therefore, whatever we do, whatever we plan, whatever we execute, if at the bottom of our beings we have that, ultimately, my aim is to communicate God. My aim is to communicate the love of God for the others. I think that we can solve. I know that in Belgaum, we didn't have all the structures. We didn't have all these buildings and perhaps, but Bangalore is a different one. And we should not think mission means it's just the poor people, the people who have no, they're living in huts and all. That's the, we have to go and preach. No, I think Bangalore needs more sharing of missions. And in Bangalore, where we think we have everything, we don't have anything. We don't have anything. When people have perhaps so many other things, if people have not learned to share, to give witness, perhaps they have not learned anything. And therefore, I would say the missionary dimension or the sharing, the dimension to share our love and ourselves, perhaps is much more explicitated in Bangalore than in the other countries. There it was a poor country, a poor place, a poor diocese, where we had many other needs and challenges. But I think Bangalore would have to be seen in a different way. Mission does not mean just reaching out in the sense of the poor. Mission also is for the rich, and for the rich to come closer to God.
Wonderful. Taking the subject forward, Your Grace, is this declaration of extraordinary missionary month confined to season and month, or is it a continuous process of a mission?
Surely, every Christian is a missionary. And there's no time and there's no season that you can say that this is the summer season, this is the rainy season, this is the... And we cannot compartmentalize our life also. This is missionary season, this is non-missionary season, this is perhaps the other season we cannot say. Life is a mission for us. And the Holy Father, Pope John Paul II would say, that your mission or whatever you consider as mission is stagnated, is frozen, the moment you don't share it. When you share it, it's as good as not only melt the ice, but you increase also your own faith. And therefore, one of the solutions to increase your faith is to try to share others. Perhaps the best example is a candle. A candle. When I light another candle, nothing is less for my candle. When I light 100 candles, my candle still remains, and it's I have produced lights of the 100 candles. So something like that, we have to share our faith.
That's a beautiful example that you're given, the light, sharing the light. Grace, in a very challenging environment like this, the political environment that's happening, how challenging is our mission work in the city of Bangalore?
I would say not just politics, but the society as such. We have many other challenges. And even if perhaps there are challenges, every challenge is meant to be a challenge so as to bring out something best in us. If there were no challenges, it's like a complete holiday season, a constant tourist season where everyone is happy, where there's no challenges and nothing grows, nothing happens. But every time there is a challenge, I am also challenged to respond to it. And therefore, I would say in the situation that we are, whether it's political, cultural, or the economical, these challenges that we see as challenges perhaps are also blessings in disguise for us. You know, the early church flourished, not when everything was peaceful, but whenever there was persecutions, the blood of the martyrs was also the seed of the future faith for us.
Very true. And besides the program that we had for this month, which has been a packed program to convey the message of Extraordinary Missionary Month to the ends of the city of Bangalore, what plans do you have, Your Grace, on board to take this missionary work further in the days to come?
Yeah, I would say that we have made a beginning. Perhaps earlier it was restricted to just Mission Sunday, one day in the year when we made strong collections, and I'm very happy. Bangalore is a place where people are generous. People are come out and help in need. And therefore, it was just for a day. But now we have extended to a month. But then this would give us a more impetus to carry on. If we could do it for 1 month, perhaps why not another month, another year also. So in that sense, and I would say the challenging things for us is, first of all, deepen our faith. We have seen in this month, many of our churches had missions, preachings, faith experiences. Perhaps this could be continued a little more to deepen each one's faith, to be sincere and before God to say that I am preparing for myself for this mission. I am part of this mission. The second day, I would say, not just the church type of programs, but also we have to learn to share ourselves with the others. I would say in some way, when a person reaches out to the other, he also practices his faith. Practices his faith. And therefore, next year, as you have perhaps heard it, I would like to take it as a year of the poor. There are two sides of the coin. The side where we adore God. At the same time, we adore God in the poor. We see God in the poor. And therefore, next year, I've said perhaps we could take it as a year of the poor, to be conscious of the poor around us. That would also be, I would say, the practicing of our evangelization or actual realistic proclamation to the
That's wonderful. That's a really encouraging decision that you plan to declare the next year as the year of the poor. But then, Grace, before I conclude, how much you feel the pious organization have been supportive to your mission work?
I am quite encouraged and edified. You know, this month, the missionary month, was a revelation. We had just one meeting before I went to Rome. And I was very diffident, perhaps, but then the response for that meeting, it was itself so much. In my absence, the Vicar Generals had another big meeting for which I was told that everyone was almost competing to say that we will do this, we will do this, which means we have this innate potential and energy which surely is useful. And therefore the different organizations and associations not only have started, perhaps they are kindled, and years to come, perhaps next year we'll involve more and more people, and may not be just 1 month, as I said, we can flow over to the others. So the response of the associations, the different commissions, the different apostolates has been very, very encouraging. And I think Bangalore is a really good place. God has blessed us in spite of many challenges. Let me not say that everything is perfect. We have a lot of challenges. We have challenges of languages, of cultures, of city, of the rural areas, the poor, the rich, the specially abled. With all these challenges, which perhaps we can take as opportunities for us, I think there is a great future.
Wonderful. Grace, do you have any message for people who are watching this program?
Surely, I'm grateful, first of all, for this occasion that has been given to me, that I'm just 1.5 years here. But I'm very much touched by the response of the people when I go to the churches, when I go for the celebration of the sacraments, the way people respond. And more than anything else, I'm edified with the dedication of our priests. Of our priests, they are, unlike Belgaum, I said, we were just 100 families, 200 families was maximum. But here there are priests who are handling 500, 600 families with so much work, but still available. I would say, surely they are constrained from so many sides, but still that they have good and wanted and faithful, dedicated. That is also a good sign of this thing for me. I would say Bangalore has a great future. It's only that we have to put ourselves into action, and God will produce the results.
Thank you very much, Grace. It's wonderful having you here this morning. Thank you for the wisdom, words of wisdom that you have shared to all of us. And we assure our prayers for you in your pastoral ministry and the administrative responsibility that you have, such a big guys. Thank you, Grace. Thank you, dear friends, for watching this message. God bless you.